Good morning, friends. I am Rajan Prasad, and at present you are viewing my channel Raj Phototech. In this episode, we will learn how to do white balance in Lightroom. White balance in digital photography means adjusting colors so that the image looks more natural. We go through the process of adjusting color to primarily get rid of color cast in order to match the picture with what we saw when we took it. Why do we have to do this? Because the most light sources such as the sun, light bulbs, flashlight, etc. do not emit purely white color. The human brain processes the information that comes from our eyes and automatically adjusts the color temperature. So we normally see the colors correctly. That is why if you took a white sheet of paper and look at it outside, it would most likely look as white as if it looked indoors. What most people do not realize is that there is a huge difference in color temperature between the bright sunlight and indoors tungsten light. Digital camera or sensor detects, so you have to correct it, and this correction is called white balance. Lightroom has a set of tools that you can use to adjust white balance in your images. To see these at work, I have opened an image in develop module. At the top of your basic panel, here you can see the various white balance adjustment tools. First, you see these white balance options. Click on this double arrow. The drop-down list will show you some options for adjusting white balance. What is shown here will vary depending on the file format of images captured. If your image is in RAW format, then the white balance drop-down list will contain the same options as you have on your camera for setting white balance. This image is a RAW file, so you are seeing all the options you get inside the camera. You may be surprised to know that if you are shooting in RAW format, then there is no need to set the white balance in camera. You can set it here. To adjust the white balance in the selected image, you can select an option from the white balance drop-down list to use to fix the image. Or you can use it as a starting point and then fine-tune the result. As you can see that this image is taken in tungsten light, and so I am clicking on tungsten, and you can see that the white balance of the image is corrected in one click. You can also click on auto, and this also corrects the image. Now I am taking a JPEG file to show you the difference in white balancing. This is a JPEG file. Now open the white balance option, and as you can see here that you are now provided only three options: as sort, auto and custom. Try auto and you can see white balance is not corrected. This is due to the insufficient data in JPEG image, and this is one of the other advantages of using RAW image. We will correct this image using different white balance tool. The second way is to manually adjust the temperature slider to add warmth or remove it from the image. Drag the slider to the left to add blue tint to the image, or to the right to add a yellow tint to it to warm the image. As I am doing with this image, use the tint slider to balance out any excess magenta or green in the image. Drag towards the right to add magenta to the image and cancelling out any green tint, and drag to left to add a green tint, cancelling out any unwanted magenta. Now I am taking the raw image and correcting with the temperature sliders just to show you. If you have not subscribed my channel as yet, kindly subscribe it. And also press the bell icon to get notification of the latest tutorials. The third way to adjust white balance is to use white balance selector. You can select the tool by clicking on it or by pressing the shortcut W. From the white balance toolbar under the image, you can select options that make the white balance tool easier to use. I suggest you to deselect auto dismiss, as you can then click on the image in various places to attempt to fix it. If you
have auto dismiss enabled, you will only be able to click once before the selector is dismissed. So if that fix is not perfect, then you will need to select the tool again to attempt another fix. This is a cumbersome way to work, so I prefer to disable auto dismiss. If you click the show loop checkbox, then you will see a 5x5 grid beside the mouse cursor. The central point in the grid is the pixel that you are currently targeting and which will be used to adjust the image if you click. This grid makes it easier for you to pick the collect point in the image to adjust. The size of the grid can be increased or decreased using the scale option in the toolbar. At the bottom of the color target itself are the RGB percentage value of the pixel under the cursor. These values tell you if the pixel is neutral or not. If it is neutral, then the percentage of R, G and B will be equal. If they are not equal, then there is a color cast in the pixel. To balance the image using the white balance selector, click on a pixel that you think should be neutral gray, not white or black. You may take help of the RGB percent value here to search the neutral gray. This is why in studio some professionals place a small gray card and in processing they click on it to correct their image white balance. When you do so, Lightroom will adjust the image so that the selected pixel is a neutral gray, and as a result all the color images will change and white balance is adjusted. I have found that a good approach to take is experiment with white balance selector to see the effect on the image by selecting different pixels to adjust, then choose the most aesthetically pleasant result. I am now applying the white balance selector on the other image to show you the result. You should be aware that adjusting image white balance is to an extent a subjective assessment, so there is no one value that is correct. There are instead a myriad of different results that can be achieved, so look for one that is pleasing to you. In most cases, viewers prefer to see some warmth in the photographs as they are more pleasing to the eyes. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Meet you again in next tutorial. Bye for now. Have a nice day. I hope you enjoyed our tutorial. Kindly subscribe and like our video channel for more interesting video tutorials. If you want to get notification about our upcoming tutorials, kindly press the bell icon. See you again in the next tutorial. Goodbye and have a nice day.